This is how to write net acid-base reactions and determine the value of K when the following aqueous solutions are mixed. The first one is nitric acid and sodium carbonate. Nitric acid, if you look at the Ka value of it, is a strong acid. So an aqueous solution of nitric acid actually consists of hydronium and nitrate. Sodium carbonate is an ionic compound, so an aqueous solution actually consists of sodium ions and carbonate ions. All right, well, sodium is neither an acid or a base. Hydronium is an acid. And nitrate and carbonate could be bases. Nitrate is a very weak base, and carbonate is a much stronger basic material, so we'll use the carbonate as our base. So here's our reaction. Hydronium plus carbonate. And now I will write the conjugates. The conjugate base of hydronium is water. The conjugate acid of carbonate is hydrogen carbonate. Now to find the equilibrium constant. The K for this reaction is equal to the Ka of the reacting acid over the Ka of the produced acid. So, my reacting acid is hydronium. My produced acid is hydrogen carbonate. So these values you'll have to find in the table, but I've provided them here. For HNO3, Ka is much, much greater than 1. But if you look at the table, K is equal to 1 for hydronium. So this would be 1 over the Ka of hydrogen carbonate, which is 4.7 times 10 to the minus 11. So I will put that in my calculator. And the value I get is 2.1 times 10 to the 10th power. So that is a very strong reaction and will proceed all the way to the right. Let's try the next one. Nitrous acid and potassium sulfate. Nitrous acid is a weak acid, so an aqueous solution of nitrous acid consists mostly of HNO2. An aqueous solution of potassium sulfate consists of potassium ions and sulfate ions. Alright, well, potassium is not on our acid-base table, but nitrous acid is an acid, sulfate is a base, so my reaction has to be HNO2. Plus sulfate going to the conjugate base, which is NO2, 1 minus, and the conjugate acid of sulfate, which is HSO4, 1 minus. Now for the equilibrium constant. This would be Ka of HNO2 over Ka of my produced acid, which is HSO3-. So that will give me 4 times 10 to the minus 4 divided by 1.2 times 10 to the minus 2. This comes out to be 3.3 times 10 to the minus 2. Not a terribly good reaction. So convention says use a double-sided arrow. It's in equilibrium and it actually prefers the reactant side more than the product side. Your Web sign isn't sensitive about this, but convention is that if it's an equilibrium reaction, we write equilibrium arrows. Okay, the last one here is sodium acetate and phosphoric acid. So an aqueous solution of sodium acetate is going to contain Na plus and acetate ions, which have a 1 minus charge. Phosphoric acid is a weak acid, so an aqueous solution will contain H3PO4. All right, well, I've only got two choices, and phosphoric acid is my acid, acetate is my base. So we will write H3PO4 plus C2H3O2 1 minus going to conjugates. Now, although phosphoric acid can lose 3 protons, when we write these reactions, we do them 1 proton loss at a time. So we're just going to write H2PO4 1 minus aqueous as the conjugate base, and HC2H3O2 aqueous as our conjugate acid. Alright, now for our equilibrium constant. That would be the Ka of phosphoric acid over the Ka of the conjugate acid that I made, which is acetic acid. So this turns out to be 7.5 times 10 to the minus 3 divided by 1.8 times 10 to the minus 5, which is equal to 4.2 times 10 to the second power. Okay, by convention, if it is a K that is greater than 1,000, one uses a single arrow to the right, and if K is less than 1,000, one uses equilibrium arrows. So, you know, technically I'll use equilibrium arrows on this one. And that's how to write net acid-base reactions.